Haki is a power that lies dormant in all the world's creatures. Presence, fighting spirit, and intimidation. It's not so different from the things that humans can naturally sense, such as these. The act of not doubting. That is strength. Hello and welcome to One Piece 101, the series that breaks down everyone and everything in the One Piece world. Today, we are going to be inspecting the dormant power system that exists within the One Piece world, Haki. Haki is a highly mysterious latent potential that exists within every living being in the One Piece world, although very few of those beings ever become aware of its presence, and even fewer come to harness its benefits. Beyond that, Haki is a very difficult existence to quantify because it isn't actually one singular thing such as Ki from Dragon Ball or Nen from Hunter x Hunter. Haki is actually a broader term used to describe three separate phenomena accessible to living beings. Quite specifically, those are Kenbunshoku, otherwise known as Observation Haki, Busoshoku, or Armament Haki, and finally Haushoku, better known as Conqueror's Haki. So let's begin with the wonderful world of Observation Haki. Principally speaking, this is the ability to sense the presence of other living beings. This presence manifests itself as an aura, shaped like the being itself, with no real three-dimensional details. It's very akin to looking at a silhouette, really, and this form of sight is particularly useful because it grants the user vision of beings who may be concealed by something or who are particularly far away, both of which were applicable to, say, Usopp when he engaged in Observation Haki to fire his bagworm at Sugar during the Dressrosa arc. Observation Haki can also be used as an alternative to those who are blind, such as Marine Admiral Fujitora, who exclusively sees the world through the aura of others. It is also possible to use this aura to directly judge the strength of others, although this does require a high level of mastery to perform accurately and en masse, as demonstrated by Silver's Ray Lee. But Observation Haki also has more diverse users that will generally manifest depending on the needs of the individual in question. To illustrate, Otohime was able to use Observation Haki to sense and even directly empathize with the emotions of others. Meanwhile, more combat-focused individuals such as Luffy can use this brand of Haki to read and predict an opponent's moves slightly before they perform them in battle, sort of like an incredibly short premonition, allowing the user to adjust their own movement accordingly. However, if trained enough, then it is even possible to use Observation Haki to see several full seconds into the future, and not just in vague aura-like formations either. As the first prominent user of future sight in the series, Charlotte Katakuri was able to discern complex and detailed future situations. This ability comes with a caveat though, which is that he must remain perfectly calm to look into the future. But that can also be said to be a prerequisite of all Observation Haki. It always functions more optimally when the user is in a more tranquil state of mind. So in essence, Observation Haki provides its user with knowledge that can show them where their target is, what they're going to do, and even how they're feeling. Next up is Armament Haki, which is the art of harnessing one's spirit to coat various parts of their body or even objects in a sort of armor around themselves. If you're familiar with the Rokushiki techniques, the general idea of Armament Haki is very similar to that of Tekai. The difference being that Tekai is entirely reliant on a user's physical strength, while Armament Haki relies on willpower and life force. Armament Haki can be applied in two different forms, one of which is completely invisible and is achieved by lightly coating oneself in spiritual force. However, when this is taken a step further and the user decides to clad themselves in a heavy concentration of Armament Haki, then it turns the affected area black, visually indicating to the regular person that you probably don't want to get hit by whatever that is. However, it has been implied by Charlotte Katakuri that there is a level of Armament Haki even greater than this, which may be what he used when his arms and hands turned rectangular in his fight against Luffy. However, whether this is a true manifestation of that higher level, or whether it was simply an added effect from Katakuri's Devil Fruit is unknown at the point of this recording. Users are not restricted to coating simple limbs though, and should they invest enough life force, they can also coat their entire bodies in Armament Haki, turning them into quite formidable opponents, although the efficiency of doing so is arguable. Apart from the generally increased power, the main benefit of Armament Haki is that it allows the user to bypass an opponent's Devil Fruit power, which is very notable when it comes to Logia users, as Armament Haki serves as the only real recourse to dealing with them outside of their natural counter element. With that said, Armament Haki is also most effective against Paramecia users, whose bodies are permanently altered, allowing them to take damage as if they had no Devil Fruit abilities whatsoever. It should also be said that Armament Haki does not nullify Devil Fruit powers like, say, Sea Stone does, rather it allows the user to hit the substantial body of the Devil Fruit wielding adversary. And one final word on Armament Haki, the power it provides is not a be-all and end-all. It is still highly influenced by the base strength of the user. So for example, in the case of two people fighting with equal levels of Armament Haki, the outcome of such a clash will be determined by physical strength. It's actually even possible to overpower a person's Armament Haki with raw strength alone, although that kind of power is very difficult to generate. Transitioning into the last of the three, we have Conqueror's Haki. Now this class is particularly special because it is the only one impossible to access through training alone. In order to make use of Conqueror's force haki, the user must be born with it. And to put it simply, it allows the user to manifest their willpower and exert it quite violently upon others. A common result of this overpowering of the will of another individual is having them rendered immediately unconscious by the experience. Not only that, but victims of conqueror's haki can experience more long-term effects, such as the sensation of chills running throughout their body upon awakening. As a result, the greatest advantage of this ability is what I would call fodder control, quickly dispatching legions of weaker enemies so that we can move on to the main event. Although while this usage is commonly manifested in a big radial burst, more advanced users of conqueror's haki are able to choose the target of their willpower directly. Furthermore, continuous use of conqueror's haki will begin to physically affect the surrounding environment by creating shockwaves similar to that of the Guragura no Mi. It is said that only one in several million people are born with this power, and according to the ever-reliable source that is, Treble, this is because Conqueror's Haki is an ability used to determine one's quality as a king or leader, chosen by divine power. And while I'm skeptical of believing anything this mucus baron has to say, it cannot be denied that most people in the series who possess it either have a regal position, such as Boa Hancock, who is known as the Pirate Empress, are striving for a regal position, such as Monkey D. Luffy, who wants to become the Pirate King, or have a regal epithet, like Silver's Rayleigh, who is known as the Dark King. But there you have it. Three general areas of haki. As stated in the beginning of the video, most people in this world will go their entire lives without ever learning of its existence, but in the Grand Line, especially in the New World, these abilities are more or less essential for survival. Which is unfortunate for most pirates, marines, or revolutionaries, because developing an awareness of these key abilities naturally is nigh on impossible, and they only seem to manifest themselves in moments of extreme stress, you know, hard-fought battles and the like. In fact, Luffy and the Straw Hats endured the entire first half of their journey completely unaware of haki. But even if you are lucky enough to find someone to teach you the basics and unlock your latent abilities, there is no amount of training that can advance your haki usage to the very top levels, as Silver's Rayleigh has stated that true advancement in the realm of haki only occurs during extreme use in battle, which is something we've seen firsthand with Luffy attempting to develop his observation haki against Katakuri. So sadly for most of civilization, that's not an appealing idea at all. But for those who are willing to push themselves to the very brink of destruction, as well as survive to tell the tale, then the entire world awaits. Some more fun facts about haki. Despite not being named until well after a decade of production, the very first use of haki was actually in the very first chapter of the series, in which Shanks invoked Conqueror's haki to scare off the Lord of the Coast. Although sadly, he only did this after he had lost his arm. Observation haki also made a fairly early appearance in the series, in the grand scheme of things anyway, as it was commonly used during the Skypiea arc, although the citizens referred to it as mantra instead. Just as I stated that Conqueror's Haki is the rarest form of Haki, it should also be stated that the most commonly demonstrated type in the series is Armament Haki. Haki itself is one of those words that can have a ton of different meanings when translated into English, some of which being vigor, ambition, drive, spirit, willpower, and most literally, supreme ki. Despite its rarity, the ability to use some form of haki is a requirement to become a vice admiral of the marines. In fact, it's very potentially a requirement to be able to use both armament and observation haki, but that is unconfirmed at the time of this recording. And finally, a truly useless fact. Al Pacino, the non-canon alpaca canon, is capable of using armament haki. But that pretty much does it for haki. If you enjoyed this video and the content this channel produces in general, then please do consider donating to the Grand Line Review Patreon, because the support of all of you amazing people is what continues to make this channel possible. Also, do check out my Teespring store if you're interested in shirts, hoodies, and other miscellaneous items, with the proceeds going directly to support the channel as well. And if you'd like to join the fun at any time, then please do head over to my Discord server, where a wide array of shenaniganry takes place on a daily basis. And finally, please do comment with who, what, or where you'd like to see featured in the next One Piece 101.